Hello students, I am Dr. Meenakshi Maur, Assistant Professor Zoology, Sri Samlaji Government College, Manpia, Chittorgarh. So, today my topic is Arthropoda Classification, Part 2. In previous lecture, I explained all the 7 subphylums of Arthropoda in Arthropoda Classification, Part 1, except subphylum 3, that is Mandibulata. So today my main focus is on subphylum 3, Mandibulata. So first of all, there is a quick revision of classification of Arthropoda. So Arthropoda comprises of 7 subphylums. First is Trilobita Morpha, second Chelicerata, third Mandibulata, fourth Onychophora, fifth Tardigrada, sixth Pentastomata, and seventh Pycnogonida. The subphylum 2 Chelicerata comprises of 2 classes, Myriostomata and Arachnida. Mandibulata comprises of 3 classes, Crustacea, Myriapoda and Insecta. So today I am going to discuss this part of the classification, that is subphylum 3 Mandibulata and its 3 classes, Crustacea, Myriapoda and Insecta in detail. So subphylum 3 Mandibulata. They are mandible-bearing arthropods. Body is divided into head, thorax and appendages. Head appendages are 1 or 2 pairs of antenna, 1 pair of jaws or mandibles and 1 pair of maxillae. The compound eyes are common. This subphylum is divided into 3 classes, Crustacea, Myriapoda and Insecta. So first is class. First, Crustacea. Crusta means shell. So shell-bearing arthropods are Crustacea. This class includes prawns, crabs, lobsters, crabfish, etc. They are mostly marine, but few are freshwater as well. Exoskeleton is chitinous, hard and limy, that is calcareous. They have cephalothorax, means head and thorax, often fused to form cephalothorax. So this is a cephalothorax. Head and thorax get fused and form cephalothorax. Cephalic appendages are in 5 pairs. So first is antennae, second is antennae, third is mandibles, then first maxillae, second maxillae. So they are 5 pairs of appendages, 2 pairs of antennae, mandibles, pair of first maxilla and pair of second maxilla. All the appendages are biramous. Respiration by gills or general body surface in small forms. Excretion occurs by antenna or green glands. Sensory organs include statocyst, compound eyes and antennae. Histocyst is used for balancing, compound eyes for sight and antennae for the sensing things. Gonopores are paired. Development is direct or indirect, which involves several larval stages, but the basic larva is nauplius. So examples are Palemon or Balanus. So here the picture of Palemon, where you can see this is a carapace, this is a long antenna, this is a short antenna, this is a chillet legs, these are pleopoids, telson, uropod, abdominal segments. So this is a Palemon. One more example is Balanus. Then second class is a Myriapoda. Myrios means 10,000, podos means foot. So they are exclusively terrestrial, air-breathing, mandibular arthropods. Their body is worm-like, which is made up of head and elongated trunk, and they have many similar leg-bearing segments. Antenna is 1 pair, jaws are 3 pairs, and lacks more than 11 pairs. Respiration by trachea. Spiracles are arranged segmentally. Excretion by one or two pairs of malphigent tubules. Sexes are separate, gonad is single, gonadotes are paired. So here you can see examples of Myriapoda. Actually, this class includes millipedes and centipedes. So Spirobolus is millipede. Its body you can see elongated, subcylindrical, and legs are two pairs on each trunk segment, mandibles and maxillae one pair, and this is a Spirobolus. Then second is Scolopander. Scolopander is centipedes, leg one pair on each trunk segment, and mandibles one pair, maxillae two pairs. And one more thing in Scolopander is that first pair of leg form poison claws. So examples of Myriapoda are Spirobolus, Julus, Scolopander, Poropus, or Scutigerella. Now third class is Insecta. It includes insects. Body is made up of head, which is 6 few segments, thorax is 3 segments, and abdomen up to 11 segments. So body is divided into head, thorax, and abdomen. These insects are present all habitats except the marine habitats. Head bears compound eyes, that is one pair, antennae one pair, mandible one pair, and maxillae two pairs. Mouth parts are modified for different feeding habit. Thorax with three pairs of jointed legs, and hence its name is Hexapoda as well. And thorax may also bear one or two pairs of wings. Respiration is by trachea. Spiracles are lateral in them. Excretory organs are malphigent tubules. Insects are uricotoly. They excrete uric acid. They are unisexual. Developments include metamorphosis. So development is usually with metamorphosis. Example is musca, lepisma, and there are so many examples. Walking stick, that is a phasmida, earwig, stonefly, tree cricket, dragonfly, thysanura, sting bug, cabbage butterflies, scarab beetle, thrips. So there are so many examples of insects. Here insects are divided into two subclasses, that is a pterygota and apterygota. Pterygota are winged insects, and apterygota are wingless insects. They are primitively, apterygota are primitively wingless insects. Their abdomen are with several cervical and style-like appendages, and they do not show they show very little or no metamorphosis. But pterygota, in them wings are present, secondary lost in some. They don't have abdominal appendages except cervical. Metamorphosis is present, which may be complete or incomplete. Now pterygota are again divided into two groups: Entopterygota and Exopterygota. So there is a difference between Entopterygota and Exopterygota. Entopterygota means internal winged forms. Actually, they develop wings inside the body, and they undergo an elaborate metamorphosis, which involves pupal stage. Examples are butterflies, beetles, bees, fleas, lacewings, scorpion flies, caddies. Then, and while Exopterygota are external winged forms, they develop wings on the outside their bodies, and they do not go through pupal stages. Examples are grasshopper, cricket, cockroaches, bugs, aphids, dragonflies, termites, sucking flies, stone flies, earwigs, stick and leaf insects, may flies at three lies. So insecta comprises of two subclass, pterygota, it's a winged insects, and apterygota means wingless insects. Pterygota have two groups, endopterygota and exopterygota. So today I discussed general outline of classification of arthropoda. Then subphylum is divided into three classes: crustacea, myriapoda and insecta. Crustacea includes prawns, crabs, lobsters. Examples is palemon. Myriapoda includes millipedes and centipedes. Examples are spirobolus, julus, scolopander, porpoise, scoticerella. Then class insecta. It comprises of insects. Insects may be winged insects or wingless insects. Winged insects are pterygota and wingless insects are apterygota. Winged insects are again divided to endopterygota and exopterygota. Endopterygota develop wings inside the body and they may undergo elaborate metamorphosis which involve pupal stage, and exopterygota develop wings on the outside their bodies and they do not go through a pupal stage. So examples, you can see there are so many examples of endopterygota and exopterygota. Thank you.